Hello students, in today's class we will learn about one of the illustration under deduction under section 80G relating to the deduction under section 80G. So see the question. Mr. Murali gives the following particulars for the previous year. GTA is rupees 10 lakh. So GTA is given 10 lakh. This GTA includes long term capital gain 1 lakh, short term capital gain taxable at 15% 40,000. He paid 22,000 as medical insurance premium for self, 30,000 to SBI towards educational loan of his daughter. Interest is rupees 20,000 and principal amount is 10,000. He made following donation during the previous year. So he made the following donations during the previous year. We have to find whether those donations is deductible under section 80G, whether he can claim a deduction under section 80G. So first one is Rajiv Gandhi Foundation rupees 30,000, National Foundation for Communal Harmony rupees 20,000, National Defence Fund rupees 25,000, Indian Institute of Science National Eminence rupees 30,000, Government for Construction of Hospital Building rupees 20,000, Books for Local School rupees 50,000, Local Temple for Renovation 18,000, Government Health Center for Family Planning 15,000, Renovation of Taj Mahal 15,000. Compute his total income for assessment year 2020-21. So for the assessment year 2020-21, we have to compute the total income or taxable income. So here they have given GTA and the some of the deductions relating to medical insurance premium, educational loan that is relating to ATE and ATG deduction is given. So with the those deductions and GTA, we have to compute his total income. So this question is asked for the 2015 year question. Now see the question. So GTA is given. From GTA we have to deduct the deduction under section 80. GTA is directly given here in the question, that is 10 lakh. This includes long term capital gain 1 lakh, short term capital gain taxable at 15% 40,000. So this is a short term capital gain and long term capital gain is required for while calculating ATA, adjusted total income, for the computing the ATG deductions with limit deductions. Next, he paid rupees 22,000 medical insurance premium for self. So medical insurance premium for self 22,000. Here they have not given the ages for Mr. Murali individual, so no age information is given. So we can take 22,000 maximum limit we can take as a 25,000 or 50,000. Age is here not given, so 22,000 maximum limit we can take. Then rupees 30,000 to SBI towards educational loan, interest on educational loan can be, if an individual makes payment to the interest on education loan, then he can claim a deduction under section 80E, that is for interest amount. So this is a 30,000 amount, total amount to SBI towards education loan of his daughter. So daughter's loan he can claim deduction. So here only for the interest payment he can claim deduction. So here interest is 20,000, principal amount is 10,000. So totally he paid 30,000 to the educational loan. So he can claim interest amount 20,000 under section 80E, interest on education loan, that is for his daughter 20,000 he can claim. There is no restriction of amount, fixed amount to claim here under 80E. Whatever interest paid can be claimed as a deduction under section 80E. Next, he made following donation during the previous year. So during the previous year he has made some of the donation. We have to find which all the donations comes under without limit, which all comes under with limit, and which for which he can claim 100% deduction and 50% deduction. Now we'll see one by one. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation comes here. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation, it is comes under donation without limit 50%. So we have to remember, so first we have to read all those deduction. After that only we have to solve the solution. So Rajiv Gandhi Foundation's 30,000. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation comes under without limit, and that also 50% deduction. Next one, National Foundation for Communal Harmony, NFCH. This is comes under without limit 100%. National Foundation for Communal Harmony, that comes under without limit 100% deduction. Next one, NDF, National Defense Fund. This is comes under without limit 100% deduction. Without limit 100% deduction. Indian Institute of Science, National Eminence. So this is an approved institution, approved educational institution, National Eminence. So it is comes under without limit 100%. Government for Construction of Hospital Building comes under with the limit 50%. So that is Government for Construction of Building, that is comes under with the limit 50%. Under with the limit 100% will get only family planning. Importantly, you will get only family planning. Rest are with the under with the limit. So Government for Construction of Hospital Building with the limit 50%. Books for local school, books is donation in kind, is not allowed eligible for deduction. Local temple for renovation, local temple is not allowed for deduction. Only notified temple is allowed. See here, only notified temples we have to take, and with the limit deduction only for notified temple. Local colleges we can take, but not a local temple, mosque, gurudwara. It should be a notified places, so then only he can claim a deduction. Local temple for renovation is not allowed eligible for deduction. Next, Government Health Center for Family Planning. Family planning with the limit 100%. Family planning with the limit 100%. Next one is renovation of Taj Mahal. Renovation of Taj Mahal is a notified place here. Other places, Taj Mahal is a notified places. So renovation to Taj Mahal is deductible under section ATG in that with the limit 50%. Compute his total income. Yes, now we will calculate the solution. That is solution number one for the illustration number one. So here they asked to compute the total income for assessment year 2020-21. So we have to write the heading computation of total income for the assessment year 2020-21 of Mr. Murali. So computation of total income for assessment year 2020-21 of Mr. Murali. So we have to draw three column here, three amount column and one particulars column. One particular column and two amount column, three amount column, amount to rupees, amount to rupees, amount to rupees. So to find out total income, we have to take first GTI, gross total income. Gross total income is directly given in the question. So first we have to write the gross total income. So gross total income, how much? So here GTI 10 lakh is given for previous year. Following particulars for the previous year, GTI is 10 lakh is given. So we have to take 10 lakh GTI here. Gross total income, gross total income, in the last column we have to take 10 lakh. Next, from GTA he can claim a deductions, that is deductions under section 80. Under that we have to take one by one deductions. So here first deduction he given is he paid 22,000 to medical insurance premium for self. That is a deduction he can claim under 80D. And one more deduction is interest on education loan. That is 20,000 is interest on education loan. So two deduction we have to take here. So 80D medical insurance premium amount is 22,000. That we have to write in the second column, 22,000. And 80E interest on education loan, that is amount is 20,000. Amount is 20,000 is interest. You should not take the principal amount, only the interest value. Total value should not take. Next deduction here, they have not given other deductions. They have given about 80G. So we have to take 80G. So this 80G is relating to donations. So under that we have to take without limit and with the limit conditions. So first we have to take without limit items. First one is without limit. Under without limit, we have to write one by one, all the items we have to take, 100% as well as 50%, all the items one by one we have to take. So in that first one, Rajiv Gandhi Foundation, this is comes under without limit. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation comes under without limit. Amount how much? Rajiv Gandhi Foundation 30,000. Don't take 50% here. Actually, Rajiv Gandhi Foundation is a deduction eligible for 50%. Right here 50%, but don't take the 50% value. Actual value 30,000 itself you have to take here. Don't take the 15,000 here, 30,000. Next without limit item is deduction is National Foundation for Communal Harmony. National Foundation for Communal Harmony, this is a 100%. So that is how much? 20,000. Next NDF, NDF also 100%. NDF, how much amount? Amount is 25,000. NDF is 25,000. Next one is the Indian Institute of Science National Eminence. So Indian Institute of Science National Eminence, this is also of 100% amount, without limit 100%, that is 30,000. Next one is Government Construction for Hospital Building, this is with the limit, we have to take later. Books, not eligible. Local Temple, not eligible. Government Health Center for Family Planning, this is with the limit, we have to take later. Renovation of Taj Mahal also with the limit, we have to take later. So now you have to total, that is 30,000 plus 20,000 plus 25,000 plus 30,000, 30, 60, 70, 80. 1,05,000, total 1,05,000 is here without limit total, 1,05,000. Next we have to take with the limit. Here under without limit we have only 50% Rajiv Gandhi. Next rest 3 item is 100% one. Next second one under donations after without limit, next one is with the limit. So under with the limit we have to write one by one. So which all have with the limit? This one over. Government for construction of hospital building. Government for construction of hospital building, amount how much? 20,000. This is comes under 50%. Don't take 50% here. Full amount we have to take. Then books is not eligible. Local temple not eligible. Government health center for family planning. Family planning is how much? Family planning is how much? 15,000. So 15,000 we have to take. So family planning comes here 100%. So without limit, most of the item is 50%. Those we get 100% right there. We can easily identify. So here 150% and here 100%. Next one is renovation to Taj Mahal. Amount is renovation for Taj Mahal amount is 15,000. So total 3 items. So how much? 30 plus 20, 50,000. So here condition for with the limit, total with the limit or 10% of ATA. 10% of ATA, whichever is less we have to take. 10% of ATA, whichever is less we have to take. Whichever is less we have to take here. So 10% of ATI we have to compute. ATI equal to how much? What? So how to compute? Condition is with the limit donations or 10% of ATI, whichever is less. ATI equal to GTI minus long term capital gain, short term capital gain and exempt income and deductions income relating to this section and income deduction under section 80C to ATU. So in this problem we have GTI. In this problem we have GTI 10 lakh. Long term capital given capital gain is given. Short term capital gain at 15% also given. Then we have other incomes are not there here. We have the deductions from ATD 22,000, ATE 20,000. So we have two deductions. So with the help of that we can find ATA. So ATA equal to GTI minus long term capital gain minus short term capital gain at 15% minus, and here they have given section 80D and minus 80E. So totally we have these amounts. So GTA, how much? GTA is equal to 10 lakh. Then long term capital gain, how much? Long term capital gain 1 lakh and short term is 40,000. So long term capital gain 1 lakh, short term capital gain 40,000, and then ATD, how much? ATD 22,000, ATD 22,000, and ATE is 20,000. So now we have to calculate what is a ATA. So that is how much? 8,18,000. 8,18,000 is a total ATA. 8,18,000 is a total ATA. So here we have to take 10% of ATA. So 8,18,000, 10% means we have to cross 10, we have to cut. So how much? 81,800. So in that, whichever is less means we have to take 50,000 here. Whichever is less means 50,000, that is 50,000 we have to take under with the limit. So here you should remember that while calculating ATA, we have to take the deductions from ATC to ATU except ATG. So in this problem, they have given only ATD and ATE, and we should exclude this ATG. We are calculating now ATG, so ATG we cannot deduct here. To calculate this ATG, so ATD and ATE we have to deduct from GTA in order to arrive at ATA. So we'll get whichever is less means 850,000. So now we have to total without limit how much? 1,05,000, and with the limit total how much? Comparing to 10% of ATA, how much? 1,05,000 plus 50,000, that is 1,55,000 is the total. 1,55,000. This total we should stop here. In order to find the next step, we need this total, so we are writing this total. So here, draw two line here. So our name is total A. This is the name, total A. We have to provide total A. Next we have to find which all the deduction 100% deductions and which all 50%. Altogether we have to take 100% deduction. So in the without limit, Rajiv Gandhi Foundation is 50% means we have to exclude 30,000 from 1,05,000, or we can take 20,000 plus 25,000 plus 30,000, or we can take 1,05,000 minus 30,000, whatever we get all are 100%. So we'll take one by one. This first one is Rajiv Gandhi Foundation is 50%. This one is not taken under 100% deduction. So the next one is N National Foundation for Communal Harmony plus next one is NDF plus IIC, Indian Institute of Science. Plus then 100%. Here only 3 are 100%. This one is 50%. Here under with the limit, only family planning is a 100%. Rest other is 50%. So family planning plus family planning. So this much we have to add. So NFCH amount how much? 20,000. 20,000 plus 25,000 plus IIS National Eminence 30,000 plus family planning 15,000. So this is a total 100% deduction available contribution. For this amount he can get complete 100% deduction. So totally 90,000. Total 90,000 is a deduction under 100% deduction. Next is this is named as a B. This is named as B. Next we have to take 50% of balance. So balance, how to find A minus B? So A how much? 155,000. 155,000 minus 90,000 is a B. So balance how much? 1000 is equal to, we'll get 65,000. So that is the balance value. So on 65,000 we have to take 50%. 65,000 into 50% is equal to 32,500. So this is a under 50%. So total 90,000 and 100% deduction and 32,500 for the 50% deduction. So total deduction is 90,000 plus 32,500, 122,500. So here while adding, we should not add this total A. We have to add only 100% deduction and 50% deduction. Total 122,500 is a deduction under Section 80G. That is the deduction he is going to claim under Section 80G, and the next deduction under Section 80D and 80E, the total 42,000 plus 122,500 is the total deduction, that is 164,500. So from 10 lakh, if you deduct 164,500, that answer will be 8,35,500 is the total income or taxable income for the assessment year 2020-21 for the Mr. Murali. So actual his GTA how much? 10 lakh. His total income is 10 lakh. So here deduction is going to claim is 22,000 and 122,500 for the various donations. So 164,500 he is going to claim a deduction here. So his taxable income now is reduced because of these deductions. So here he has been reduced taxable income. The total taxable income is 8,35,500. On this income he has to pay tax. If he is not having these deductions, if he has not taken a medical insurance premium, if he has not taken a loan, educational loan, or if he has not contributed to these donations, then he has to pay tax on this GTA 10 lakh. On 10 lakh he has to pay tax. Now after claiming the deduction, he has to pay tax on this 8,33,500. So in order to reduce the tax liability, the government has given various deductions so the SSC can take benefit from these deductions. Now you should write note for the items which have been excluded. So here we have excluded one, books for local school. The books donation in kind is not eligible. Books, write note. First note is, so donation in kind, that is books, not eligible for deduction under Section 80G. Second one is local temple for renovation. Local temple for renovation also not eligible for deduction. Only notified temple, if it is notified temple, then it is eligible for deduction.